Hi everybody, I'm Henry Lee from blueheronarts.com, an online store for Chinese art supplies. Today we're going to have a lesson, a basic introduction to Chinese goldfish painting. I've done some goldfish painting before, but some viewer asked me how to show them how to do the basic strokes. So here I have two illustrations. The upper one is more like a regular typical fish. You might recall carp or koi fish. And the lower one is what we mean by goldfish in Chinese art. The goldfish is a symbol of abundance, wealth, because the sound, the yu, a fish, Jinyu means gold, fish, I mean Jinyu in Chinese sounds like gold and jade. So gold and jade, Jinyu, also goldfish, symbolize wealth, as in Chinese phrase or idioms like Jinyu man tang, or gold and jade filled up in the hao, or in the pool, actually tang meaning pool, another same sound character of different meanings. So we borrow those good, we use these good meaning words in festivals like Chinese New Year. We use lian lian you yu, or extra, you know, enough wealth for the year, you know. So we always use fish associated with good fortune. Okay, to do the goldfish in freestyle, of course you can do this in elaborated style or gongbi. In outline, then color it. But normally we do it in freehand style. Here's the sequence. The first stroke, just a quick pulling stroke, and then add two small strokes to the front to make it a head. And a little stroke, if you could finish in one, you can do it in one, otherwise you can put a little handle for the tail. So let me do this again. A fat stroke, and two short strokes, and a tail handle, not yet the tail. Do it again. So this could be different colored fish, right? But let me add a little ink. We use a little glue in the water to reduce the smearing, the bleeding when you dilute ink. And you can use a little dark ink. One stroke, two, okay, then reload again with light ink, very gray ink. You don't want it too dark on the tail. This is a, you can use either the wolf hair brush, or for best result, use the let me change this. The combination brush for the tail. Soak it first. And then load it with very diluted ink. With a peach sap glue. powder. So get a light tone and a little bit ink to the tip. Notice the double tail you do in 4 strokes. Okay, first press and then lift. Okay. Press and then lift and then pull. The other side. I don't really change hand, just go with the chameleon direction. See, lift and press and lift, okay? And then add the mouth. Do this one. The lip is thick. You can do it in 2 strokes. And the eye is, it's kind of big, like goldfish. This side is only one, a little skinned. Okay, now back to the light ink to outline the body. Okay, or you can do the body first if you want. So notice the belly is thicker, bigger than the chest. So they're not the same size. Just few strokes for the fins. The back fin usually omitted. You can use different ink. Some goldfish has a black spot with a red spot. So next time I'm going to do a color one. I use vermilion and some orange color. And dab a little bit rouge. Just one stroke for the head. And then I'll use light ink to draw some outline. Some fish is called the lion head. the tall top on the head. And just do the tail. Heavy, lit. If you can do the bamboo leaves, I think this is similar. Press and lifting. You can use a relatively dry brush, but go very slow when you practice. Okay. This paper is very absorbent. It's a triple shine. Use some pure ink to dot the eye. You can use a small brush for that purpose. I had a small weasel brush. Added the swimming thing. Okay, this is just to show you the sequence. When I actually do, I would okay. You can change directions from you change the direction of the head, the arrow, you might call it. So let me do three head this time. It's too dry. By the way, this is a double shrimp. Double layer strand paper. Let's do one here. And I'll change it to black. So you always combine different color, not just the red or gold, but different color. Then you remember the arrowhead thing. So we got enough already. Then use a little dark rouge. Add the fish mouth. And this one is dark ink. And use in this case dark ink for the eye. This perspective, you don't see the eye actually. And then, dilute the into the other eyes also. Now dilute the ink with water. And we got this three-section brush washer, very convenient. So, draw a little line for the belly and the body. not use. You can hold the brush perpendicular or slant, depends which way you like. If you hold the brush perpendicularly to the paper, you make the brush head flat, and then just draw like that. Head on top, on the bottom. Also dark some dark spots if you see the model fish. You can draw some water weeds, or just leave it, leave the background white and sunny. Side seal or corner seal, if you like, says longevity, prolonged year. This is my last name Li, my signature. That completes the picture. I hope you got some idea, and practice makes perfect. Happy painting. Bye bye.